Hello everyone, welcome again. Today we will solve lead code problem 2, which is adding two numbers. The problem statement is, you are given two non-empty linked lists representing two non-negative integers. The digits are stored in reverse order and each of their nodes contain a single digit. Add the two numbers and return the sum as a linked list. You may assume the two numbers do not contain any leading zero except the number 0 itself. So here is the example. So let us try to put this in the whiteboard. And we are given the linked list 2, 4, 3, and the other linked list is 5, 6, and 4. Representing these in terms of numeric digits, numericals will convert this into the number 342. And the same thing for the second linked list will be 465. We try adding up these things. So we first add the units place, then tens place, then hundreds place. So 5 plus 2 is 7, 6 plus 4 is 10, and we'll put carry 1 here and 0 here. 4 plus 3 plus carry 1, which is 807. And let us try to do the same addition using the linked list. So in the linked list, the first element that is seen here is ones place, and this is tens place, and this is hundreds place. And let's try to add this up. 5 plus 2 is 7, then 6 plus 4 is 10. We will store 0 here and carry 1 here, and 3 plus 4 plus carry is 8. So our solution is the same. So everything will be represented in the reverse order in the linked list. This way we can solve the linked list. And let us consider an edge case where L1 not equal to L2. Let me put this up 2, 4, 3, and we have a situation where we have 5, 6, 4, and we have one more element 9. In this scenario, so let's try to add this up. 5 plus 2 gives us 7, 6 plus 4 is 10. We put carry 1 here, and 3 plus 4 plus 1 is 8. And when we try to add up, we have an empty element, so which is null. So we cannot add up to a null element. So we will put this as 0 and add these things. 9 plus 0 is 9. So done. We have this case. And let us consider one more situation where we have a carry leftover. So for this, I can consider 2, 4, 3, and again 5, 6, and 9. So we try to add this. 5 plus 2 is 7, and 6 plus 4 is 10. We put 0 here and 1 here. And 9 plus 3 plus 1 will give us 13. So 3 here and carry 1 here. So we have additional carry, and when we end up submitting this as a result, it will give us the wrong answer. So we have additional carry here. What we do is, we put a 0 here and a 0 here, and we try to add up, and we extend our linked list as 0 plus 1 plus 1, which becomes 1. So now answer is 1307. So we try to, so let us try to code this out, and we can see the results. So let us code this out. Before coding the solution, let us see what we have been given. We have been given the definition of the list node. The list node has a value and the pointer to the next node. So when we are initiating the list node, if we just give a list node without any value, it will be pointed to number 0 and the next node will be none. And let us try to put the solution. And for this, for storing the result of L1 plus L2, I will use a variable called result, and I'll call this with empty list node. And let me also initiate a current node and point it to results itself. For storing the carry, we can use one variable, and in the beginning let me put it 0. So the condition to check while there is an element in L1 or there is an element in L2 or there is a carry. So initially carry is 0, but at the edge case which we have discussed already. So we have a carry one here. So even if there are no elements in list one and list no, if there is a carry, you should be proceeding with this. And how can we solve this boundary condition, like we don't have any element here, is by using this approach. So let me initialize val1 and I will call it as l1 dot val if there is an element in l1, else I will replace it with 0. So this if else condition will solve our problem for such scenarios where there is no element, the l1 and l2 are not equal. And val2 equal to l2 dot val l2 else val, the sum of val1 plus val2. And we also need to add the carry. So this statement will actually do the any sum. 2 plus 5 plus carry, or 4 plus 6 plus carry, or 3 plus 4 plus carry, whatever we have discussed, that will be happening in this step. So again, we need to separate the carry. Like when we add 6 and 4, we got the result as 10. We need to separate 0 and 1. For separating the 0 and 1, we use the division method. So the carry will now become L divided by 10. We got the carry now, and the val becomes val modulo divided by 10. So val will now contain 0 and carry will contain 1 in case of adding 6 and 4. And we got our value, and we need to assign this to the add this to the linked list. So we need to create a list node of this value. Let us create list node of value, and we can assign this next node to the next of the current dot next equal to list node, and then we need to update l1 and l2 now. So now first update current so that our current will point to the next pointer, and let us now update l1 equal to l1 dot next if l1 else none, l2 equal to l2 dot next if l2 else none. And we are done with the solution. And what should be returning? Should we be returning the result? What happens when we return the result? So when we return the result directly, we are initially creating an empty list node. So empty list node will also be printed in the result. So our actual solution will be from result.next. So here is the solution. Let us go through it once again. So I am initializing a empty list node and assigning that empty list node to the current, and I am also initializing a carry as 0. And while there is an element in L1 or L2, or there is a carry left over, I'll be doing this loop. So value 1 will be L1.val if there is an element in L1, else it will assume it to be 0. Same with value 2, and I will add this value 1, value 2 and carry and put this in val variable, and carry will be val divided by 10, and our actual value will be val modulo divided by 10. So now I will assign current dot next element. So empty, now in the beginning stage we have the current element as list node, so list node dot next will becomes the next node dot value, and current, let me update the pointers as current equal to current dot next, and l1 equal to l1 dot next, and l2 equal to l2 dot next. And to handle the unequal list sizes, we use this if and else none and if and else 0 values here, and we can return the result.next as our result. Let us submit this solution and see how it performs. So I have submitted, and it is performing faster than 91% of the Python 3. So thanks for watching. Hope this helps you. Happy coding.